What goes up and never comes down. Guess.
What?
Your age.
And if there are more.
Oh my god, the kids in Shantipur are constantly quizzing you on riddles. Not able to think.
Okay, we didn't. We'll ask one.
Okay.
Imagine that you are in a jungle caught with 10 lions. And they have surrounded you from all sides.
Okay.
What are you gonna do?
Do I have a choice? I definitely can't run. My name is Shilpa Raj and I'm 25 years old, and I was born in this in a poor village in rural Karnataka. And in our area, female infanticide was very frequent. When I was born, my father was disappointed that I was a girl, and he said his first reaction was throw her in the garbage pit. So it was my grandmother who stood up to him and said, I'm not going to let you do that. And ever since then, my whole life has been a big roller coaster of different experiences and ups and downs, and like anybody else's life, with both the good and the bad. But my life changed in a very significant way when I was picked to study in a free boarding school that offered quality education for children from poor homes. So no one in my family for generations ever had had an opportunity like that. So the school is called Shanti Bhavan, and I was the school focuses on just taking one child per family, because they believe in spreading the impact to as many families as they can, and they believe that one empowered child is enough to carry the entire family forward. So I was that lucky one from my family. So I left home at the age of 4, and ever since then my life's always been very different from those of my siblings and my parents who lived back in the village, who remained there and still remain there. And their life is one of constant hardship and uncertainty, whereas I've had an opportunity to enjoy so many things, enjoy a wonderful education and the opportunities that an education such as the one I received has offered me. I had a group of people consisting of teachers and caretakers who truly loved me and wanted the best for me. And when they saw that I was in a situation of utter chaos and emotional turmoil, they all came together to support me, and they served and they continue to serve as my strongest support system. So I was very lucky to have a group of people who've had my back for all this time. But children like my sister have not been that lucky, you know. They count on their parents to look after them, to guide them, but the parents themselves are broken within, because they themselves have gone through so much turmoil in their lives. My father back then, when I was around the age of 4, used to work as a bootlegger. It was the family business where men would engage in the trade of brewing illicit liquor and selling it. My father would go out at night selling liquor from village to village. And because it was illegal, you know, he had no choice but to do it at night to avoid getting caught by the police. But later on, he got a better job, though it wasn't any less hard than the first one. And the job consisted of chasing away the wild elephants that would come into our village to feast upon the sugarcane plantation. So sometimes they would even come into the human settlement area and destroy homes. So there have been casualties too. My father's lost a few of his colleagues who've been trampled by elephants. So that's why when around the age of 14 or 15 when I was trying to really piece together my true sense of identity. I realized that a core element of my identity would always be one of being his daughter. And though I had had a chance to live a better life than him, I did not ever think of wanting to renounce him or leave him behind and move ahead selfishly in life. So by naming my book as The Elephant Chaser's Daughter, I acknowledge my relationship with him, and I openly talk about the good and the bad that consists in this relationship that we share. As a child, you know, we are selfish at times and we're insensitive, and sometimes I would feel ashamed of the fact that my father didn't know English, or when he would come to see me in school and I would be ashamed of how poorly he was dressed, or that he couldn't sign, write his name in the school register and he had to put his thumbprint, or he wasn't wearing sandals. Those things made me feel ashamed of him. And then only in the process of writing this book, you know, I moved on from being ashamed to being someone who was understanding and empathetic, and I no longer looked down upon them from a place of privilege. I realized that I was the privileged one.
प्यासी हूँ मैं तुमको पिला के थक गई हूँ मोड़ों पे रुक के